December 6, 1907, the worst mining disaster in American history occurs in the community of Monongah, West Virginia. Around 10 o'clock in the morning, when a full force of some 380 men and boys, some as young as 8 years old, had begun their shift, mines number 6 and 8 on the Consolidated Coal Company shook from the impact of an underground explosion. A total of some 362 men and boys lost their lives, leaving some 250 widows and over 1,000 children without support. The explosion disrupted the ventilation systems, causing an effluence of deadly gases to be trapped within the mines. Those on the surface concluded that the men and boys who survived the explosion and cave-in would soon succumb to the gases. The poisonous fumes permeated the mines, causing rescuers to work in relays as they had no protective devices, such as gas masks, and can only work in the deadly atmosphere for 15 minutes before resurfacing. Some of the would-be rescuers were seriously injured by inhaling the vapors and had to be taken away for medical treatment. Crowds gathered at the entrances of the two mines waiting for news about their friends and family trapped in the mines. The news was disheartening. Many of the bodies brought up were mangled and burned. A temporary morgue had been set up in a partially completed bank building to accommodate the victims. Bodies were identified by their personal effects, and some were never identified. The explosion was thought to have been caused by the ignition of black damp, otherwise known as methane. This in turn ignited the highly flammable coal dust, which is found in all West Virginia coal mines. What ignited the black damp is unknown, although two theories emerged: carelessness with an open lamp or dynamite blast gone wrong. It remains one of the worst coal mine disasters in U.S. history, and we shall never forget the lessons learned that fateful day.